Hey, what's up, everybody? My name's Troy Osorno, but many of you already know me as Troy the X-Ray Boy. And I received 25 of your questions because you wanted to know more about what I do here in X-Ray. So let's just jump right into these questions. Number one, was it difficult for you to become an X-Ray tech? Yes and no. When I was a senior in high school, my daughter was born. So going to school and being a parent, that's a huge challenge. But luckily for me, I was able to excel in school because I had my daughter there motivating me to work hard and get good grades. Question two, what do you like best about your work? It's really about who you're working with and where you're working at. And I know that there are many X-ray techs that are stuck working in an emergency room in a stressful environment, and it's really, really draining to be around patient after patient that is having the worst day of their life. They're coming in with some severe injuries. Sometimes it's life-threatening. And that's not for everyone. Not everyone can work in an ER. Luckily for me, I work in a small clinic here at the Maui Medical Group in Pukalani. And I have a great group of nurses and doctors here. And the patients that come in, they usually just walk right in. It's nothing serious. And 99% of them are friendly. So that's always a plus. Number three, what college did you graduate from? I graduated from Kapi'olani Community College's Maui Radiology Program in 2009. Now you can't do that program. It's since been taken away. So the only place you can study radiology is on Oahu at KCC's campus there. Number four, is it difficult to be an X-ray person? To be an X-ray person, no, it's not difficult at all. To become an X-ray person, yes. And I think that's how it is with any job. When you go to school and you're getting your degree, it's very hard. But here in X-ray, it's a very simple job. It's actually the easiest job that I've ever had. But getting to this job, that was the hard part. Number five, how long have you been a radiology tech? I've been working as an X-ray tech here for 7 years, and I've always worked for the Maui Medical Group. Number six, what made you become an X-ray technician? Well, back in intermediate school, my dad got rushed to the emergency room with a life-threatening condition. And luckily, because of the doctors, nurses, and techs, he was able to make it through despite having a low chance of survival. So ever since that moment in my life, I've always been interested in the medical field. Number seven, can you get cancer from being exposed to X-rays? And this is a very common question that we get, especially when you see things in the news about nuclear power plant accidents, and that brings up concerns about radiation exposure. The honest truth is that, yes, any exposure to an X-ray can eventually lead to cancer. But that is why it's important for your doctor to determine if the benefits of the X-ray exam outweigh the risks. And technologists like myself are trained to make sure that you're safe during these exams. So there are many different things that we do to keep you safe. Here are the top four. Number one, we make sure that the patient is not pregnant because a developing baby is the most sensitive to radiation. Number two, we make sure that we focus the X-ray beam so that it is only being exposed over the area of interest. Number three is we do as few X-rays as possible. And number four is we use these lead aprons to cover the more radiation sensitive areas of your body during the tests. So there's many different things that we do to protect patients during the X-rays and keep that chance to a minimum. Number eight, what is the most exciting part about your job? For excitement, I would say it's probably the variety of patients that we get and the variety of what you do. Because for the most part, patients are coming in, they can just walk in, they're middle-aged, and maybe 7 out of 10 x-rays, it's a patient that needs to have a chest x-ray. So those are just two views. It's really simple to do. But once in a while, you'll have a patient that comes in that is not doing so well. Maybe they're in a wheelchair. Maybe it's a baby. Sometimes you have to x-ray a different body part, like their skull, maybe their foot, their elbow. You never know what you're going to get. And not knowing and having that variety, that's what's most exciting for me in this job. Number 9, what type of education do you need? Well, that varies state to state, but for the most part, when you go to a radiology program, you have to first take your prerequisites. So those are the courses like math, English, medical terminology, and of course anatomy, which is the most important one. And once you have those classes finished, then you go on to apply for a radiology program. The radiology program itself lasts 2 years, and the prerequisites last 2 years. So altogether, you're looking at about 4 years of going to college. The next question is number 10. Since when did you know you wanted to be an x-ray tech? Well, I always knew since intermediate school that I wanted to go into the medical field. But a couple years after my dad got sent to the ER, I met an x-ray tech at the gym where I worked out. And he was actually going to KCC's program on Oahu. And when he was here on Maui during his vacations, he would tell me about how much fun the program was and what a great career radiology is to be in. So that sparked my interest in this. Number 11, what type of education or training is necessary? Well, you already know about the prerequisites and about the radiology program, but as far as training goes, during that radiology program, you're studying, you're going into the lab doing experiments, and you're doing lots of hands-on time. So that training is probably the best part of your schooling. Those are during your clinical rotations, and you go all over to the emergency room, the operating room, and different clinics so you can get the full experience of what are the different jobs available for x-ray techs. And you don't get paid, but it's really the most important part of school because you're learning hands-on what it means to be an x-ray tech. Number 12, what is the worst thing about this job? Again, that just depends on where you're working. If you're working at an ER, it can be very stressful. If you're working at the operating room, that can be a lot of pressure for you to operate your x-ray machine quickly because the surgeon is waiting for you. And for me here at the clinic, the worst thing, it's hard to say because I love my job so much, but if I had to say something, it's probably the days that are really, really busy, like after a holiday or a Monday when there's lots of patients that are coming in and they all need x-rays right away. And I don't like those days because I have to rush and I can't spend as much time with each patient as I normally do. Next question is number 13. Do you have fun with your job? Well, this is the most fun that I've ever had in my entire life. I've had many jobs, but working as a radiology tech has by far been the best and most fun job. Working at the Maui Medical Group is fun because we always have fun contests. We're competing against the different departments during Halloween for cash prizes. So there's always something fun going on here. And it's really fun to be part of this organization. Number 14, is it really your passion? Well, I heard this saying once, it's an old saying, it goes, if you can find a job that you love, you'll never work a day in your life. And I'm so lucky that that's the case for me. I actually look forward to coming to work every morning, and radiology, working as an x-ray tech, I found that that is my passion. Number 15, do you have free medical? Well, I wish that it was free because it's not cheap. Every month I pay about $280 for my daughter and I to have dental and medical insurance. But the good news is if we go to the Maui Medical Group and see a doctor with our group, we don't have to pay a copay. Or if we need to have some sort of diagnostic test, such as an x-ray or MRI or ultrasound, we don't have to pay anything. The Maui Medical Group pays for that portion. Number 16, How long did it take till you became a radiographer? It took me 5 years. Normally you can get it done in 4, but I was just waiting for the Maui program to begin. So I had finished my prerequisites. I had a year to wait before the program started. And so during that 1 year break, I took my math class again because originally I got a C in math and I wanted to get a better grade to increase my chances of getting into the radiology program. So during that 1 year break, I was able to do that and bump up my math score. Number 17, what is your favorite thing about your job? By far, it's probably just helping patients. Many patients that come in, they are sick, maybe they have some sort of broken bone, and you're trying to find out what's going on. And it's a really rewarding thing to be able to help the patient and find out what's going on with them. Number 18, what college degree did you need to be a radiologist? Well, I have to clear up something here. There are many different names for my job. There's Radiology Tech, X-ray Tech, Radiographer, Radiologic Technologist, that's the fanciest one. But radiologist, that is the actual physician that interprets the X-ray. So they are a doctor. We send the X-rays when we're done to the radiologist, and they will look at the X-ray and create a report with all the details about the study. So if you want to be a radiologist, you have to go to school for a very long time, because first you have to go to 4 years of college and then 4 years of medical school so that you can become a doctor first. Then they go into their radiology programs. So yeah, radiologists, that's the doctor, and they go to school for a very, very long time. Next question is number 19. How do you keep yourself safe while taking X-rays? Well, you already know about patient safety. As far as technologist safety, each time we take an X-ray, we stand behind a protective wall, and that keeps us safe from getting X-rayed too. Next up, we have got number 20. What do you think is the most important thing for someone considering the field to know? Well, just think about it. This job, you're a photographer and you're taking pictures of the human body. So you really have to have a good foundation of the skeleton and also the other organs and systems in the body, because in X-ray, we look at all types of body parts. We have chest X-rays looking at the heart and the lungs. You have different X-rays for the skeletal system if there's a break. And also we look at the digestive system by giving a patient a drink called barium, which will highlight their digestive structures. So you have to really know everything about anatomy to work in this field. Number 21, what was your job before you became an X-ray tech? Well, before I did this, I worked as a bellman and a valet over at the Fairmont Kealani Hotel in Wailea. And that was really a great experience for me because it taught me how to give great customer service and how to be a hard worker. And of course, the tips were good. But best of all, I was able to learn how to speak the Filipino dialect of Ilocano while I was there, because many of my friends in housekeeping would teach me every day. And I continue to use that here in my current job. Many of the patients are Filipino and they don't speak any English, so I have to tell the patient to take a deep breath in. Umangis katina onog nana. So it was a really valuable experience for me working at the hotel. Next question is number 22. How is it like working with patients? I think it's a lot of fun. Like I mentioned, you get to learn different languages, because the patients sometimes they don't speak English, so you get to meet many patients from all over, and it's really great to find out different things about the people in your community. And number 23 is, do you make a lot of money? Well, yes, we do. As radiology techs, we make a lot of money if you consider the amount of training that you go through to get this job. I mean, you go to school for about 4 years, and the national average for X-ray techs is $27 per hour. And that's just the average. So a lot of times you'll be making more than that. And you could be making less than that, but that just really depends on where you work. And if you have further training, such as certification in CT or MRI, you can make even more money. Number 24. Besides this job, what other job would you want to do? Well, I love this job and I don't plan to do anything else. If I had to say something, I would probably go with going to more schools to do presentations, because I love to teach people about what I've learned in radiology, and it's really fun to go to the schools and bring different props that I've saved over the years and show the students how much fun radiology can be. And number 25, last but not least, what classes do you need in college to become an x-ray tech, and how hard are they? Well, you guys know about the prerequisites, those basic core classes. The radiology program itself, that is probably the hardest part of schooling, because you start to focus more on the specifics of what's going on in x-ray. That x-ray tube you see behind me, when you're in the rad tech program, you have to learn everything about it. You have to learn exactly what's happening inside of there, how is an x-ray being created, how is the machine set up, about the electronics. So you have to learn about that aspect of the job, and then you also have to learn about patient care. So you learn about how to take care of patients and how to position them for these exams. So during the radiology program itself, that's when it gets tricky. It gets a little hard, but like I mentioned earlier, the actual job itself is very simple, and you have to be able to work hard through college, get your degree, and if you want to have this kind of great job where you look forward to coming into work, you get paid well, you have to be willing to pay your dues. So that is all we have for today. 25 questions, that's done. So if you guys have any more questions, please, you guys can contact me. Here's my information. And as I'm ending this video, I wanted to do one final thing. I recently got this. It's actually a magic skull ring, and the instructions said that it has some sort of magical property. You just have to put the ring on and then snap your fingers. So let's see what happens.